praising and thanking God.
God, you promised this, and now I can die in peace. I've seen the one who will save all peoples, the light for all the world.
There was also a woman prophet called Anna in the temple. She was very old and had lived in the temple since her husband died a long time before. At that moment, Anna came up to Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. She thanked God, and she talked to everyone in the temple about Jesus.
Wow.
Well, we weren't expecting that.
When we talk to God and say sorry, we can also ask him to speak to us. And we can listen for and hear the Spirit's voice inside us, telling the right thing to do.
But Julie, oh,
I've missed
the page. I'm working with Anderson. 2 years.
Rewind.
2 years.
Didn't you learn the lines?
Sorry, we changed puppets and I only had the first and the third change names, so there we go. Sorry, so where was I? Jesus wasn't a washing of bad things away, but a washing away of his old life as a carpenter and the starting of his new life and telling everybody how to be God's friend.
Julie.
I wish you wouldn't keep saying that, Milo. Yes, Milo.
But in the story, after Jesus comes out of the water, a white bird sits on him. Didn't Jesus mind? I'd mind. I wouldn't want a bird to sit on me, because it might poop and my mum would be mad and she'd have to wash my clothes again.
Milo, that bird wasn't a real bird. It was the Holy Spirit that came and filled Jesus ready for his new work. The Holy Spirit is usually invisible, but God wanted his people to know his Spirit filled Jesus. So that's why it came down as a dove.
So, is a duck going to come in and sit on Milo's head when he's baptised?
No, Dexter, I don't expect that will happen. But who knows with God? But that Milo's so little. He's not very old. He can't have done very many bad things yet. Not like some Milos we know. So, why does he need to be baptised?
In baptism, we're washed free from all our sins, the things we've done wrong in the past, and what we'll do in the future if we keep to
clean on the inside to be with God. So we need to say sorry every day for the things we do wrong. As Milo grows, his parents and godparents will remind him that God washes away what he does wrong when he says sorry to God.
So, when we do something wrong, bad or wrong, if we say sorry to God, then he washes us clean again.
That's right, Jasper. I think some people are going to be spending a lot of time talking to God in that case. But when we talk to God and say sorry, we can also ask him to speak to us. And we can listen for and hear the Spirit's voice inside us, telling us the right thing to do.
Are we finished yet? Are we going to baptise Milo now?
Not quite yet. I first got to light the candle. So, parents, can you keep your children down below?
You mean that great big one there?
Yeah, this great big one here.
Why are you lighting that?
Right.
I know why. It's what Simeon said in our story. Jesus came to be the light of the world. It shows the fire.
Dad, come up and gather around. We've got things to say. Come up and gather around so we can see. Okay. Alright. First thing, not just about Ian and Ross and Milo. It's about all of us. So, we bring Milo, Julian Woodward to baptism, knowing that Jesus died and rose again for him, and trusting in the promise that God hears and answers prayer. We pray that in Jesus Christ he'll know the forgiveness of his sins and the new life of the Spirit. As he grows up, he will need the help and encouragement of the Christian community so that he may learn what it means to be a Christian, and in due course come to speak for himself for confirmation. As part of the Church of Christ, we all have a duty to support him by prayer, example, and teaching. So, people of God, will you welcome Milo, Julian, Woodward, uphold him in his new life in Christ, and encourage this whole family by prayer and support?
With the help of God, we will.
Okay, next time make it a bit louder. So, parents and godparents, this is you. We're so glad you're bringing Milo for baptism. Today we are trusting God for his growth in faith. Will you pray for him, help him to belong to his local church, and show him by your example what it means to follow Jesus?
With the help of God, we will.
Good. Okay. Right. Jesus called himself the light of the world. In baptism, God calls us to make a radical choice to leave behind our self-centered way of living and to put Jesus at the center of all we do. To follow Christ means saying no to sin and saying yes to Jesus. It's a radical choice of stepping out of darkness into light. Therefore, I ask all of us, do you turn away from those things which you know to be wrong, which you know cause pain and sorrow to those around you, and grieve God's heart of love?
I turn away from them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ, the Saviour, whose death on the cross makes forgiveness from God a reality, and whose living presence helps you to become the person he made you to be?
I turn to Jesus Christ.
You're getting quieter, come on. Right. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to profess together with this family the faith of the church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe and trust in him.
This is the faith. This is our faith. Mom, this is the faith of the church.
This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
But it's going to be put to a very, very low. Now, water, Finn might help me in this, but we'll see. Water is an extraordinary substance, and unlike the result when hydrogen and oxygen combine, and still in many ways a mystery. The colour of our planet is defined by water, and it shapes our physical existence. We use water in baptism because its physical significance gives us pictures of an important spiritual truth. It also reminds us of our own baptism, doesn't it, Flynn? You're going to come back, Flynn?
Thank you.
rest of us. Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. I proudly, as a disciple
of Christ, against sin, the world, and the devil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life.
May God, who has received you by baptism into his church, pour upon you the riches of his grace, that within the company of Christ's chosen people, you may daily be renewed by his anointing spirit and come to the inheritance of the saints in glory. Amen.
Amen.
Faithful and loving God, bless those who care for Mary, and grant them your gifts of love, wisdom, and faith. Pour upon them your healing and reconciling love, and protect their home from all evil. Fill them with the light of your presence, and establish them in the joy of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now all you have to do is to welcome Milo into our church family. So, there is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. By one Spirit we're all baptized into one body. Milo, we welcome you
into the fellowship of faith.
We are
children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you.
So, as we do as tradition. Right. So, sorry, we can't do anything. So, baptize Milo. And now we are going to do a song which is quite appropriate, I hope.
You can throw the shop in the small
space. Bubbling up. So, please stand and we'll sing our song. Bubbling up.
Bubbling up, bubbling up. To the surface. Bubbling up, bubbling up. Bubbling up, bubbling up. Bubbling up, bubbling up. To the surface. Bubbling up, bubbling up. Bubbling up, bubbling up. To the surface, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, up to the surface.
Jesus came into our dark world and said, I am the light of the world. He also challenges his friends and followers by saying, you are the light of the world. On behalf of Milo, we say, you have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life.
Shine as a light in the world, the glory of God the Father. Amen.
That's yours, Milo. And again, when you have maybe your birthday or your anniversary of your baptism, you can light it. And remember, you are the light of the world. Thank you. And a noisy light of the world. I'm getting a little bit tired. So, we've come to the end of our service, Pentacle Patrick and Sydney. And we're just going to finish with our blessing that we're going to say together. In darkness
and in light, in trouble and in joy,
help us,
Heavenly Father, to talk to you, to praise your name,
to
thank you for your goodness.
Say
sorry for the things we do wrong.
To trust
in your guidance. Amen.
Amen. Okay. So we're happy you've joined us. For those of you who are new, we do this every first Sunday of the month. So if you want to bring your children along, you are more than welcome. We have refreshments at the back, which you're happy to, or we welcome you to share with us. But Rod and Ian are having a master's party down in the hall a bit later, and they've also asked me to extend their welcome to anyone here if they want to go downstream.